Welcome back to another video. If you're new, welcome. For this video, I'm starting off with some of the XXL coffin nails from AliExpress, and then I'm also using some of the Pine base coat gel, and I am doing the Apres dupe method, and I do have a layer of peel off base coat on my natural nail, and that's because I don't plan on wearing these nails for long. But if you did plan on wearing them, then you would want to go in with the proper prep, which would just be lightly filing the shine off of your natural nail and then going in with some dehydrator and primer. And I'll have a link in the description box to the dehydrator and primer that I typically use from the brand Mia Secret. But I'm just going in and applying a thin coat of the base coat gel, and then I'm putting some inside of the nail, pressing the nail on and curing it in the lamp. Also, thank you so much, Joanne Simmons, for your comment on my previous video. I really appreciate it. Once you have all of the nails on, you can go in with a nail file and shape up around the cuticle area and then also the tip of the nail. And then once you have that on, you can go in with a layer of base coat gel and cure that in the lamp. Then you can do your design. So I'm just going in with two shades. This new color is from AliExpress, and then the purple color is from the Pine Gel Polish Kit. I'll have everything that I'm using linked in the description box. But I plan on doing an ombre, so I'm just going in with this fan brush and just kind of going back and forth pretty rapidly up and down, but staying towards the center of the nail. And then I cured that in the lamp, and now I'm going in with a second coat. And I love this method. I really do envy people who use acrylic, because they're always able to do such a nice ombre, and doing ombre with gel polish can be really difficult. But with using this method with a fan brush, I've gotten pretty good results, so I plan to stick with this method, and I really do plan on doing it more. It's a lot of designs where I want to do an ombre nail, but then I just never feel like it, because it can be a little bit of a hassle making sure that it looks nice. But yeah, using the fan brush is definitely a good hack for doing ombre with gel polish. Now for the middle finger, I'm doing a marble nail design, so I'm just going in with some of the purple and some of the white gel polish, and I'm doing a different method than I normally would. Typically, I would put down a layer of base coat gel and then put the colors inside of the base coat gel and then just kind of move that around, but I'm just going in with these colors, and I'll put them on the nail in like dots on random spots, and I'm just going in with a dotting tool to move it around. I don't know, I think that I just wanted to try this method because I saw someone's picture with a really pretty marble. They did use acrylic for it, but I just like the way the colors look, and I just wanted to try it out and see if I could do it with gel polish. It worked out pretty fine. I would say that it can be kind of a hassle to go in with a dotting tool and move all of the gel around. You don't want to put too much gel on the nail because it can be kind of hard to cure. But overall, it turned out pretty nice. So now on the pointer finger, I'm going in with some of this tape. And I plan on doing kind of like a negative space nail design. So I'm going to put the tape on, and then I'm going to go in with some of the purple gel polish at the cuticle area of the nail and the tip of the nail, leaving a clear space in the middle. Thank you. Once I have the first coat cured in the lamp, I'm going in with the second coat, and then I'm going to remove the tape and then cure the second coat in the lamp, or else it would be really hard to remove the tape. But once I have all of the tape off, I'm going to go in and go ahead and do one coat of the purple gel polish on the thumb and the pinky. I'm going to be doing glitter on the pinky and then a different little design on the thumb, but I just wanted to go ahead and get that first coat down. Now I'm going back to the pointer finger, my negative space nail, and I put a layer of base coat gel on the underside of the nail, and now I'm just putting some of these glitter flakes on the inside of the nail, and I love this design so much. It's super, super pretty. I think that this nail would look super cute matte also, but I did go ahead and make it glossy. But I just love the way it looks when people have an encapsulated nail design and then they make it matte. It just looks so pretty. But I just went ahead and cured that in the lamp. And now I'm going in with the second coat of the purple gel polish on the thumb. And that's because I'm going to put some of the glitter flakes on the thumb as well. And I'm just going to do kind of like a swirl design down the middle of the nail. Now I'm applying the second coat of the purple gel polish to the pinky, and I'm going to go over it with some glitter, and I'm just going to pour that on top and then cure that in the lamp. And this is how the set is looking so far, super pretty. You could leave it like that, but I wanted to add a little something extra. So I'm going in with this flower mold, and I'm just putting some of the gel polish inside of it. And I'm using 3 different sizes, and I am putting quite a bit. And I'm just gonna go in and wipe off some of the excess, and then I'm gonna cure that in the lamp and pop those out of the mold and place them on the ombre nail. I don't really wanna cover up the ombre, but I just thought it would look pretty on that nail along with the nude. So yeah, once I have this in, I'm just gonna wipe away some of the extra, cure it in the lamp, and then apply it. Along with the flowers, I'm also adding some AB rhinestones, and these are backless, and I think that just kind of fits this design nicely. So I'm going along the negative space and adding some rhinestones on those lines. It really wasn't necessary because the tape worked out really nice and the lines were nice and crisp, but I just wanted to add something a little extra. And then also when I add the flowers to the ring finger, I'm going to put a few stones around it as well. And I did put those into some top coat also, but I used matte top coat on the ring finger, and I think it just made that nail pop. But overall, I love the way this design turned out. I don't know if you all can tell, but I'm really ready for the springtime. I'm over all of the winter nail designs and Valentine's Day nail designs, so I really wanted to do something for the spring, and I think that with these colors, it's just perfect. It kind of gives me like a floral pastel fairy type of look, and I'm here for it. So let me know what you guys think of this nail design. I hope that you all liked it and enjoyed the video, but I'm gonna go ahead and check out now. So yeah, be sure to give this video a thumbs up, leave a comment down below, and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out on any of my upcoming videos. And be sure to stay tuned on this video until the end to see like all my little finished result photos and videos and whatnot. But yeah, I'll see you guys in the next upload. Bye.